Hello everyone, I'm Tanvi Kaur and I welcome you to this series called RBI 247. In this very series, we pick up some important financial topics and we try to discuss them with the help of different questions. So for all those who are there for the very first time on our channel, you can subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon for all latest updates and notifications. You can also join our Telegram group. In this very group, we share some free quizzes as well as the updates for all our videos. So before moving on to question number one, let me tell you that the topic which we are going to discuss today is microfinancing. So what is microfinancing? How is it doing in India? What are the existing regulations? All that will be covered today. Talking about why I am covering this topic, RBI has recently come up with some proposals relating to microfinance sector in India. That's the reason why I'll be covering this topic in detail today. So we'll start with the microfinancing, the concerns associated with the sector, what were the existing regulations, what new proposals have come up. So we'll discuss the entire session first and then we'll move to the questions related to this topic. Alright, so let's get started now. Talking about microfinancing. So what do you mean by microfinancing and why is it important? So talking about microfinance, it has been derived from two words, micro and finance. So it stands for rendering financial services to those people who are in low income category or the poor people. So rendering small amount of financial services to low income groups is called microfinancing. Microfinance is a form of financial service. ये एक type की financial service है जहाँ पे आप low income लोगों को, poor लोगों को loans देते हो, small amount of loans देते हो और बाकी financial services provide करते हो. So it's a financial service where you provide small loans and financial services to the poor and the low income households. Talking about how it is helpful, it's an economic tool which helps promote your financial inclusion. So it helps to provide the necessary funding to the poor people, to the low income groups, thereby helping them to come out of poverty line. Helping them to come out of poverty. Okay, there are people who are below poverty line as well. So it helps them by providing them the funding to carry out their businesses, to carry out the activities which might generate income for them and help them bring out from that poverty levels. Moreover, it can help them to increase their income levels, improve on their standard of living, thereby assisting all these vulnerable groups in some way or the other. Now talking about who delivers the microcredit, ये जो small loans grant करने हैं poor लोगों को, low income लोगों को, कौन सी institutions हैं, कौन से institutional channels हैं जो ये microcredit provide करेंगे. So talking about the institutional channels which can provide this microcredit include your scheduled commercial banks. So all your scheduled commercial banks which include your small finance banks also, regional rural banks also, they all can provide this microcredit. Okay, they can directly provide them or they can have link up with the self-help groups, with the business correspondents and provide these financial services to the low income groups. Then there are cooperative banks as well which provide this kind of funding. We have some NBFCs also which are into this very business. Okay, there are a separate set of NBFCs which specifically deal in microfinance and they are called microfinance institutions, the NBFC MFIs. Okay, they are NBFCs, microfinance institutions. So let us move ahead now, talking about the concerns in the microfinance sector. I have told you that RBI has come up with certain recommendations on how to improve this sector. So if this sector needs improvement, that means there are some problems already existing. So let us have a look at those problems, those concerns associated with this sector. There are two major concerns. Okay. The first one is over-indebtedness and the multiple lending. And the second one is related to the pricing, with respect to the pricing of these very loans which are granted by these microfinance institutional channels. So talking about the first concern, which is related to over-indebtedness and multiple lending. So jab aap zyada debt le lete ho jitni aapki capability hai, that is over-indebtedness. Okay, aapko aapki utni capability nahi hai ki aap pay kar paoge, but aap alag alag jagah se itna zyada loan le lete ho and later on you suffer. Taking loan beyond your capacity is over-indebtedness. Alright, now talking about India, we have a specific set of regulations related to microfinance sector, but they are only applicable to NBFC microfinance institution. हमारे पास एक proper comprehensive अच्छा खासा regulatory framework है microfinance regulate करने के लिए, लेकिन वो regulatory framework सिर्फ NBFC microfinance institutions के लिए है. जो बाकी institutional channels है, the remaining channels, this set of regulatory framework is not applicable to them. Okay, 30% might be the NBFC MFIs which are granting the loans through microfinance sector, but there are other lenders also which comprise of around 70% share. So they are not subjected to same regulations which these NBFC microfinance institutions are subject to. So what happens because of this? Because of this, the small borrowers increasingly are able to get multiple loans from several lenders. So if a person is not taking, so the small borrowers are not just taking the loans from these NBFC MFIs, but also from other lenders. आप NBFC MFIs के लिए regulatory framework है कि आप इतने तक का ही loan ले सकते हो, limits specified हैं, there are limits specified for NBFC MFIs, but those limits are not applicable to to other lenders. So what borrowers do, वो यहाँ से तो loan ले ही लेते हैं जितनी limit है, इसके अलावा बाकी amount of loan अगर उनको चाहिए तो वो बाकी lenders से ले लेते हैं. इससे क्या है, उन पे burden बढ़ जाता है और बहुत ज़्यादा debt हो जाती है जो वो later on pay नहीं कर पाते. As a result of taking multiple loans from several lenders, it leads to contributing to their indebtedness, because of which they are not able to repay the loans, and thus the lenders indulge in coercive recovery practices. फिर जैसे तैसे करके lenders अपना पैसा recover करते हैं, coercive practices use करते हैं, और बाद में ultimately जो suffer करते हैं वो होते हैं small borrowers. So ये multiple lending की वजह से over indebtedness की problem आती है, which is a major concern associated with our microfinance sector. Moving ahead to the second concern, that is related to pricing of microfinance loans. So high amount of interests are to be paid by these small borrowers. Let us see how. Now if NBFC MFIs are regulated, then whatever thresholds are specified for the interest rate, that are applicable to only these NBFC MFIs. इंटरेस्ट रेट पे लिमिट लगाई गई है कि आप इतने हद तक का ही इंटरेस्ट रेट चार्ज कर सकते हो, लेकिन क्योंकि वो रेगुलेटरी फ्रेमवर्क के अंदर लगी है तो वो सिर्फ एनबीएफसी एमएफआईज को ही एप्लीकेबल है, बाकी लेंडर्स को एप्लीकेबल नहीं है. सो व्हाट इज द कंसर्न एसोसिएटेड विद इट? व्हेन दे आर नॉट एप्लीकेबल टू एनबीएफसी एमएफआईज, इट माइट हैपन दैट दे द अदर लेंडर्स माइट चार्ज हाई, or even if they are not charging high, they try to charge the same amount which these NBFC MFIs do. Because of this, the low cost benefit of paying low interest rate which the small borrowers could have enjoyed, they are not able to enjoy. I'll explain this thing again. What happens is, NBFC MFIs ke liye interest rate specified hai, lekin ye interest rates jo hai ye baki regulatory bodies ke liye specified, baki jo bodies hai jo ye loans lend kar rahi hai unke liye nahi hai, kyunki ye framework sirf NBFC MFIs ko applicable hai. When these regulations are not applicable to other lenders, that means they can charge whatever interest rates they want. So what they do, वो लोग जो बाकी lenders हैं वो भी वही interest rate charge करते हैं जो ये NBFC MFIs charge कर रहे हैं, सेम सीलिंग के अंडर वो रेट चार्ज करते हैं. इससे हम लोगों को क्या नुकसान है, हम लोग मीन स्मॉल बोरोवर्स को क्या नुकसान है, जो माइक्रो फाइनेंस के जो पुअर लोग हैं या लो इनकम लोग हैं जो यहाँ से लोन्स ले रहे हैं, उन्हें ये नुकसान है कि बैंक से उन्हें लो इंटरेस्ट पे लोन मिल सकता था, क्योंकि बैंक अगर लार्ज स्केल पे ऑपरेट कर रहा है तो उसकी कॉस्ट कम हो सकती है, तो वो लो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स पे भी ऑफर कर सकता है लोन. बाकी इंस्टीट्यूशन जो है वो भी लो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स पे लोन ऑफर कर सकती हैं, लेकिन क्योंकि वो देखते हैं एनबीएफसी एमएफआईज इस रेट पे लोन्स दे रहे हैं, ये उनका बेंचमार्क रेट्स हैं, तो वो भी उन रेट्स के अराउंड अपने रेट सेट करके लोन्स ऑफर करते हैं, जिससे कि कॉम्पिटिशन नहीं रहता कि हम ज़्यादा लोन्स देंगे लो इंटरेस्ट रेट्स ऑफर करके, और अल्टीमेटली कस्टमर जो कि स्मॉल बोरोअर्स है जिसको लो इंटरेस्ट रेट का फ़ायदा मिल सकता था, उसको वो फ़ायदा नहीं मिल पाता. लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस अगेन इन इंग्लिश फॉर सम ऑफ दोज हु डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हिंदी. सो द रेगुलेटरी सीलिंग इज जस्ट फॉर एनबीएफसी एमएफआईज. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस व्हाट हैपेंस, द अदर lenders, they also try to charge similar rate, they also hover their interest rates around this ceiling. Now when they are also charging the same rates, the benefit which small borrowers could have enjoyed because of competition, when other lenders would have lent at lower interest rate, they can't enjoy that benefit. Also NBFC MFIs when become large in size, their cost reduces, they reap the benefits of economies of scale, and because of that their interest rates can decline, but they continue to charge the higher rate as per the ceiling, of course. Because of this, the borrowers are getting deprived of the benefits from enhanced competition, and thus they have to pay more. So pricing of microfinance is again a major concern. I hope these two points are clear, because all the regulations which exist or new proposals which have been suggested, they revolve around solving these two problems only: the problem of over-indebtedness and the pricing of microfinance loans. So let us move ahead now. As I've already told you, RBI has come up with a consultative document. So it's still a proposal, no final guidelines relating to how to deal with the microfinance sector and address the concern of over-indebtedness and to bring down the interest rates. So let us have a look at the existing guidelines and what new proposals have been suggested. So I'll talk about the existing regulation, new proposal, and why that new proposal has been suggested. First of all, talking about which kind of NBFCs can be categorized as NBFC MFI. So here's a threshold which has been specified. First of all, that NBFC should be a non-deposit NBFC. Non-deposit taking NBFC can become NBFC MFIs. Secondly, they should have a minimum net owned fund of 5 crores, which is 2 crore in northeastern region. So net owned fund will include your some of the share capital, some premium, some reserves. So minimum amount should be 5 crore. And their net assets should be a minimum of 85%. So let us see which kind of loans qualify to be an asset under NBFC MFIs. So kaun se type ke loans hain jo qualify karte hain to be the assets under NBFC MFIs. This was the definition of NBFC MFIs. Now talking about the criteria for the loans to be classified as qualifying assets. First of all, whatever loans are being disbursed to a borrower, there is a limit specified that they should not exceed 1,25,000. The annual income of the borrower should not exceed 1,25,000 in rural area and 2,00,000 for urban, semi-urban areas. So, jo bhi borrower loan le raha hai, wo us borrower ko small borrower hona chahiye, low income borrower hona chahiye. How we determine he is a small borrower or a low income group borrower? We can determine it based on their household income. So if the household income, agar us borrower ki household income 1,25,000 se zyada nahi hai, being the person is from a rural area, and if he is from a semi-urban or urban area, then uski household income 2,00,000 se zyada nahi hai, to usko jo loan diya jata hai, wo classify hota hai NBFC MFIs ka asset ki tarah. Secondly, whatever loans are being granted, the first cycle of loan should not exceed an amount of 75,000, sorry, and that for subsequent cycles 1,25,000. So aap jo bhi loan de rahe ho, pehli cycle mein jo loan de rahe ho 75,000 se zyada nahi hona chahiye, aur subsequently fir se loan de rahe ho to wo 1,25,000 se zyada nahi hona chahiye. The third criteria is that the total indebtedness of the borrower should not exceed 1,25,000, excluding loan for education and medical expenses. So borrower jo bhi loan le raha hai, uske total loans 1,25,000 se zyada nahi hone chahiye. Except agar usne education ya medical expenses ke liye loan le rakha hai. Next is that the minimum tenure of loans which exceed 30,000 is 24 months. Itne time ke liye loan do jiska amount itne se exceed kar raha hai. Then a very important point is the collateral free loans. The loans which are granted by these NBFC MFIs are collateral free. Unko koi asset girvi nahi rakhna padta, koi collateral nahi deni padti ki agar hum loan na repay kar paye to wo asset sell kar do. We'll discuss why they grant collateral free loans when I'll discuss about the new proposals, okay? Also, if they want to prepay the amount, no penalty will be there. Then a minimum of 50% of the aggregate amount of loans should be used for income generation activity. Jo bhi NBFC MFIs loan de rahe hain, 50% wo loan income generation activities ke liye use hone chahiye. It's not that you are using those loans for education purpose, for medical purpose, for other emergency cases. 50% of the loans granted should be by these NBFC MFIs are those which will help the small borrowers to do the activities which generate income for them. Next is that there should be flexibility of repayment. Borrower's choice should be given a priority. Borrower jaisa chahe waise loan repay kar sakta hai, weekly, fortnightly, monthly. Borrower ko itni flexibility honi chahiye. एंड नॉट मोर देन टू NBFCs कैन लेंड टू द सेम बोरोअर. दो से ज्यादा NBFC एक बोरोअर को नहीं देंगे. Now, why these guidelines were there? So that a person doesn't become over indebted. He has enough funding available to use for his daily expenses also. उसको सारा का सारा पैसा लोन के चुकाने में ही ना देना पड़ जाए. उसके पास कुछ पैसे बचे, इसलिए ये maximum thresholds specified हैं. These thresholds exist so that person has some funding available to meet his expenses and don't have to pay the entire amount for in the form of repayment of loans. Okay, then. Collateral free loans are offered because these people don't have enough assets available to provide as collateral. Minimum 50% for income generation activities is there so that they are utilizing the money for helping them only to come out of the poverty level. So taking into consideration the over indebtedness, these guidelines were existing. So what's the new proposal made now? As I've already told you, these regulations were just for NBFC MFIs. So the new proposal says that they should be applicable to all REs, that is regulated entities. जो बाकी lenders हैं उनको भी ये applicable होना चाहिए. The microfinance loans shall meet the collateral free loans to household, mean collateral free loans to household with income of 1,25,000 and 2,00,000 for rural urban areas. And then they have also defined who will be considered as a household. So यहाँ ये कहा गया है कि ये जो loans हैं ये बाकी regulated entities को भी ये जो भी क्राइटेरिया है ये रेगुलेशंस है ये रेगुलेटेड एंटिटीज जो बाकी हैं जिनको नहीं एप्लीकेबल थी उनको भी एप्लीकेबल होनी चाहिए. जो भी वो कोलेटरल फ्री लोन्स दे रहे हैं उनके लिए भी ये गाइडलाइंस एप्लीकेबल होनी चाहिए. अदर इंस्ट्रक्शंस इंक्लूड दैट ईच रेगुलेटेड एंटिटी शुड हैव अ प्रॉपर बोर्ड अप्रूव्ड पॉलिसी टू डिटरमाइन हाउस होल्ड इनकम. So you based on some percentage of household income you are allowed to, so based on the household income only you are granting the loans ki itni zyada income nahi hai jinki unko hi loan milenge. So there should be a proper board approved policy where you will be able to determine the household income. Then there is another provision, that is the capping of the interest and the principal payment. So that should not exceed 50%. It means कि जो भी आप लोन दे रहे हो उसके बदले में बोरोअर को बाद में इंटरेस्ट पे करना पड़ेगा और प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट तो पे करना ही पड़ेगा. तो जो भी उसका इंटरेस्ट प्लस प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट है उसकी वैल्यू उनकी इनकम के 50% के अंदर अंदर होनी चाहिए, उससे ज़्यादा नहीं. मैक्सिमम 50% ऑफ देयर हाउस होल्ड इनकम. वाई दिस इज सो आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग इट अप नाउ. But before that, let me tell you that they also offer the periodicity of payment, so flexibility should be there, no prepayment penalty, and then proper disclosure requirements are also specified. Now let us see why these suggestions have been made. First of all, why a revision is needed with respect to making it applicable to all REs? In order to solve the problem of over-indebtedness, I have already discussed this in over-indebtedness as well. कि आप एक borrower से loan ले रहे हो, एक lender से loan ले रहे हो, उसको वो guidelines applicable हैं, okay? You are taking the loan within the thresholds. But if those guidelines are not applicable to other entities, then it will lead to over-indebtedness. आप इनसे तो loan limit के अंदर लोगे, but बाकी जगहों से loan ले लोगे और आप ओवर इंडेटेड हो जाओगे और बाद में वो लोन्स नहीं रीपे कर पाओगे. दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई दीज गाइडलाइंस शुड बी एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल एंटिटीज, ताकि टोटल आप जो लोन्स ले रहे हो वो लिमिट के अंदर हो. इट इज फेयर दैट इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड ओवर इंडेटनेस ऑफ माइक्रो फाइनेंस बोरोअर्स, द रेगुलेशन शुड फोकस ऑन टोटल इंडेटनेस ऑफ दीज बोरोअर्स एंड नॉट जस्ट ऑन बोरोइंग फ्रॉम दीज NBFC MFIs. आई होप दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर नाउ. सेकेंडली, व्हाई कोलेटरल फ्री लोन्स? क्यों आपको कोलेटरल प्लेज नहीं करना पड़ेगा लोन लेने के लिए? नाउ इफ यू थिंक ऑफ दी स्मॉल बोरोअर्स, ओके, दीज लो इनकम पीपल, व्हाट डू दे हैव इन द फॉर्म ऑफ असेट टू गिव अस लो कोलेटरल? उनके पास कोई बहुत ज्यादा असेट्स नहीं होते कोलेटरल में देने के लिए. व्हाट मैक्सिमम दे हैव इज सम बेसिक हाउसहोल्ड आइटम्स, सम फर्नीचर. सो दीज आर द आइटम्स विच दे एज अ बोरोअर मे वैल्यू बट द लेंडर्स डोंट वैल्यू. आपके पास कोई छोटा सा फर्नीचर है, हाउस होल्ड आइटम्स हैं, वो आप कोलेटरल दे दोगे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा अगर आप बहुत पॉवर्टी लाइन के अंदर आते हो. अब वो असेट्स आपके लिए तो वैल्यूएबल हैं, आपके एग्जिस्टेंस के लिए. बीइंग अ स्मॉल बोरोअर दे आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जिस्टेंस बट दे आर नॉट दैट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड द लेंडर्स विल नॉट बी एबल टू फेच अ लॉट ऑफ मनी बाय सेलिंग देम ऑफ. सो दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई लो कोलेटरल, दैट्स व्हाई फ्री loans are offered which don't charge any collateral, because the borrowers were default also, they should not lose the possession of those assets which are important for their existence. All right. Now, talking about the third important thing, that why this maximum cap has been specified. अगर आप लोन लेते हो और वो आपकी हाउसहोल्ड इनकम से के 50% से भी ज्यादा है, मतलब आपका मेजर पोर्शन ऑफ इनकम जो है वो लोन रीपे करने में ही जा रहा है. सो व्हेन इंटरेस्ट व्हेन प्रिंसिपल एक्सीड्स इवन 50% ऑफ योर इनकम, दैट मींस मोस्ट ऑफ योर इनकम इज गोइंग टू पे द लोन्स. नाउ इट्स नॉट जस्ट दैट दैट पर्सन हैज टेकन अ लोन जस्ट फ्रॉम एन एनबीएफसी एंड एमएफआईज, दैट्स द लास्ट रिसॉर्ट दे ऑप्ट फॉर. First of all, they go to some money lender, they go to some friends, relatives, वहाँ से भी उन्होंने loan ले रखा होता है, they have already taken loan from there and they need to repay that as well. So अगर उनकी आधे से ज़्यादा income यहाँ के loans repay करने में चली जाएगी, बाकी की वहाँ, तो वो अपनी life को कैसे sustain कर पाएंगे, how they will meet their daily expenses, and it might happen that their loans which they have to repay surpass their income levels. So to address those concerns of over indebtedness, this cap was introduced. This cap has been suggested. The intention of proposed regulation is that households don't get strained. Moreover, they also need to have some money to meet their daily expenses. So that's the reason why 50% limit has been specified. Ki 50% amount to khali rahe apne daily expenses meet karne ke liye. So this is why these new regulations have been proposed. Talking further with respect to pricing related regulations which existed and what new proposals have been suggested. So existing NBFC MFIs, they can charge the interest rate, the processing fee subject to 1% of the loan, gross loan amount and some insurance premium. Talking about the interest rate ki bhi cap hai ki in itne isse zyada wo exceed nahi karna chahiye. So interest rate should be lower of the following two. In dono mein se jo bhi lower hai utna aap interest rate charge karoge. So the first is the cost of funds plus 10% margin if the NBFC's loan portfolio exceed 100 crores, otherwise 12%. So jitni bhi aapke fund ki cost hai us pe 10% margin add kar lo agar aapka loan portfolio 100 crore se zyada ka hai, otherwise 12%. Ye ek threshold hai. Second is 2.75 times of the average base rate of 5 largest commercial banks. So this base rate is announced by RBI from time to time. So based on this rate, 2.75 times of this rate is the next threshold. So in dono mein se jo bhi lower aayega wo interest rate ye NBFC MFIs charge kar sakte hain, and there shall be no penalty on the delayed payment. So this was the existing framework. Now despite of this framework existing, we are seeing that the borrowers are not able to reap the benefit of competition and getting the loans at low cost. So a new proposal has been suggested which says that the guidelines applicable to NBFCs should be applicable to these NBFC MFIs. जो भी guidelines NBFCs को applicable होती है, वो ही NBFC MFIs को भी applicable होंगी, which are related to proper disclosure, maintaining the transparency, having proper board approved policy and all that. So NBFC shall be guided by board approved policy, fair practices code होना चाहिए, एक disclosure transparency should be ensured. There shall be no ceiling on the interest rate. So ये जो interest rate पे ceiling थी, अब इस proposal के according कहा जा रहा है कि उसको remove कर दिया जाए, interest rate की limit हटा दी जाए. लेकिन अगर interest rate की limit हट जाएगी, उसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि जो मर्जी चाहे उतना interest rate ये लोग charge कर पाएंगे. No, there should be no ceiling on interest rate as per this proposal. But that does not mean that the usurious interest rates are charged. Okay, usurious interest rate should not be charged. Otherwise, the very purpose of having a MFI will be defeated. That's why they are still having discussions on this, and comments are needed on this very proposal, that whether it is a good fit for our microfinance sector or not. Now why have they come up with these suggestions that we should not have interest rate ceiling? I have already discussed. So in the pricing portion, which when I covered that, so the intention is to have a market mechanism to bring the lending rate downward. They have also decided that they will withdraw all pricing related instructions applicable to NBFC MFIs. So ye jo abhi humne instructions discuss kiye, jo regulations discuss ki, jo applicable tha, isko wo keh rahe hain ki ab apply na karo. They are proposing to remove this thing. And the reason is again same, to bring down the interest rates. Freeing of price cap could have an impact on borrowers in remote areas as their cost of operation is high, resulting in high interest rates initially, which will drop as businesses expand and competition picks up. So agar competition hoga aur agar wo businesses expand karenge wo economies of scale ki wajah se wo low interest rates de sakte hain, to why not give those interest rates and let borrowers enjoy the benefit of paying less. So this is the next portion which I wanted to discuss. The last thing which I want to cover are some guidelines which have been withdrawn and why they have been withdrawn. So we talked about the cycle limit, that this much amount should be paid in the first cycle, this much in the second cycle. Then we also talked about having a minimum tenure of 24 months, and we talked about the 50% amount to be used for income generation activity. And we talked, so all these three things have been proposed to be withdrawn. Other than that, they have also decided that they will withdraw the two lender norm. NBFC MFI se jo loan le rahe hain, ek person do NBFC MFI se zyada se loan nahi le sakta. Isko bhi withdraw karne ka suggestion hai. Now, why they want to withdraw these? The first thing is that the first cycle mein aap itta loan le sakte ho, second cycle mein itte tenure ke liye loan le sakte ho. Why these guidelines were existing? They were existing so that you don't take a lot of loan and become over indebted. So when we are proposing a new proposal that the loan will be linked to your household income, then there is no need of this existing regulation. Humne yahan pe aapko bataya tha that as per the new proposal, your income will be linked, your loan will be linked to your income. Ki aapka इंटरेस्ट प्लस प्रिंसिपल 50% से ज़्यादा एक्सीड नहीं करना चाहिए और उन्हें ही दिया जाएगा जिनकी हाउस होल्ड इनकम इतनी है. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी सजेस्टेड न्यू प्रपोजल वेयर दे विल समहाउ लिमिट द अमाउंट ऑफ लोन विच यू आर टेकिंग. सो इफ दोज गाइडलाइंस एग्जिस्ट, देर इज नो नीड फॉर दीज एग्जिस्टिंग गाइडलाइंस. नेक्स्ट इज दैट दे सेड दैट 50% ऑफ द लोन शुड बी यूज फॉर इनकम जनरेशन एक्टिविटीज. ओके, देर इज अ नीड टू विदड्रॉ दैट एज वेल. वाई सो? Because borrowers are not just tempted to take loans for these income generating purposes, but they need loans for other purposes as well. They need loan for meeting their education related expenses, medical expenses, to repay the existing loans which they have taken, and a lot more. Okay, lot of emergencies might come up. Now, if they will not be able to take these loans from MFIs, they will have to rely on some other measures. किसी और पे डिपेंड करना पड़ेगा, किसी और लेंडर पे जो बहुत ज़्यादा इंटरेस्ट रेट्स चार्ज करेगा. तो यहाँ से आप उन्हें कैप लगा रहे हो, पर वो दूसरी जगह से ओवर इंडेटेड हो जाएंगे. दैट्स द रीज़न व्हाई वी नीड टू रिमूव दिस वेरी रेगुलेशन एज वेल. लास्टली टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाई दे वॉन्ट टू रिमूव द नॉर्म वेयर यू शुड नॉट टेक अ लोन फ्रॉम मोर देन टू NBFC MFIs. Because now the existing guidelines will be applicable to all REs, so there is no need of this thing. Do logo se zyada se loan na lo, ye iska ye purpose tha taki aap over indebted na ho jao kisi aur se loan leke. To jab ye guidelines sari hi entities ke liye applicable hongi, to wo problem solve ho jayegi. To is existing guideline ki need nahi rahegi when this very requirement is coming into picture. That's the reason why this new proposal has been suggested. I hope all these proposals are clear, and why RBI is coming up and RBI wants to improve them, I hope that very reasons are also clear. Now let's just move on to our questions. Now you can easily answer them. Microfinance is a form of financial service which provides small loans and other financial services to the poor. Microcredit is delivered through various institutional channels. Which of the channels are included? First is included, second is also included, and NBFCs are also included. So answer is option E, all the three. Moving on to question number 2. Which of the following is or are major concerns associated with microfinance sector? We just discussed over-indebtedness, multiple lending, pricing. Okay, this is not a reason. So answer is option B, 1 and 2. Moving on to question number 3. Which of the following state the correct criteria for loans are classified under qualified assets? So answer is option A. Remaining are incorrect. This limit is incorrect. Here should be free collateral loans. Here they have written no, but they are offered flexibility. This is again low because it was income generation, not non-income generation. So answer is option A. Moving on to last question, RBI has come up with consultative document on microfinance regulations, proposing some guidelines. Which of the following existing guidelines have been proposed to be withdrawn? So, inme se kaun si withdraw karne ka bola gaya hai? Answer is option D, the two lender norm and the pricing related instructions. Collateral free loans hata diye jayenge, aisa nahi kaha gaya. Flexibility hata di jayegi, aisa bhi nahi kaha gaya. Prepayment pe penalty lagegi, aisa bhi nahi kaha gaya. And this is also not said. So, answer is option D. This was all for today's session. I hope you found this session to be useful. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.